Hi, my name is Matt Carroll. I'm an application support engineer at Agile Technologies, soon to be Keysight Technologies. Today I'm going to talk to you about the LXI Web GUI on the new Agilent AC6800 series AC power supplies. You can see here on this table I have an AC6803A, and as a load I have my E3631A basic DC power supply. So the first thing we're going to do is talk about how to find the IP address, so you can use that to open up your web browser to get to the web GUI on the instrument. So to get the IP address, we're going to hit the menu button and then go over and choose the system selection. And from system, we're going to choose the IO selection. And then we're going to choose LAN. And then we're going to choose settings. And in settings, you can see that there's something called the current IP address. So that's what we're going to use in our browser to get to the web GUI. You could also use the host name, which is also listed in here, to get to the web GUI. I prefer the IP address, so that's what I'll do, but it's really a personal preference. I put the IP address in the address bar of my web browser here, and I got to this, which is the landing page for the web GUI. So this landing page has some information like the instrument model number, the serial number, description, and some other network settings that are in the unit. The main tab we're interested in, though, is the browser web control. So I'm going to click on that. You see this kind of brings you to the main output setting page. So you could set the things like the range, the coupling, your AC voltage, your frequency, and phase sync, which is something we're going to talk about a bit later. So the range I'm going to leave at 135 volts. I'm testing a 120 volt unit. I'm going to leave the AC coupling on. I don't want to add any offsets or DC to my waveform. I'm going to set my output to 120 volts. Now this is interesting. You can actually set soft limits here. So you can set a low limit or a high limit that will kind of protect your DUT, so you can't set above or below the thresholds. Right now I'm not going to use them, though. I'm just going to set it to 120 and leave it. And for frequency, I'm just going to leave it at the standard 60 hertz setting, because AC in US, 120 volts, 60 hertz. So I'm going to go up here, I'm going to turn the output on. You can see I'm now reading 120 volts and 0.34 amps, and our output light here is lit, telling us the output is enabled. This is the main meter screen. It shows you the voltage and the current. You could hit meter again to give you more information. This includes the power measurements. And then you hit meter again, and this includes AC and DC, voltage and current and power, and peak current, and just a bunch of different measurements. This is actually a very rich selection of measurements we have available here. The next thing we're going to do is talk about how to do an inrush current test using the web GUI. So the first thing we're going to do is clear the current peak hold, and then we're going to go back to our output and go to this phase sync item that I spoke about earlier. We're going to click on it and tell it to synchronize, and we're going to set our turn on phase to 90 degrees and hit the enter button here so that it takes it. So what this is going to do is when you hit the output on button, it's going to turn the output on when the AC waveform is at 90 degrees. So after we set that all up, we're going to go back to this measure tab, and we're going to watch this current peak hold value as we turn the output on. So we're turning the output on, and you can see that our current peak hold value is 12.53 amps. So that's the highest current that it reached after we cleared it. So for this test, this would be the inrush current that we're measuring. So that was the introduction to our web GUI on the AC6800 series AC sources. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave some comments. Thanks for watching.